Oh, yes, and we got him. Oh, he's a big one.
Fantastic fish. Absolutely beautiful. We must put her back.
Wonderful new dimension to fly fishing. We're fishing of any kind of fish, but it really gives you a battle on this tackle. That's what I love.
And off he goes.
There's a beautiful little trout lake about 3/4 of a mile further up this mountain. And the beautiful thing about it is it's so remote that hardly anybody fishes it. And even when you get there, the shore is so reedy that you really need a boat to fish it properly. The trouble is getting a boat up there is virtually impossible. Except for today, that is. There's lots of portable boats on the market nowadays, but none as portable as the one I'm going to be using today. Let me show you. Well, this is it. A float tube. Now, I wouldn't recommend carrying one of these up here in a rucksack without one of these. 12 volt battery and a little blower like this saves a lot of work. And that's all there is to it, folks. 3 air compartments, just in case one disappears on you when you're out there. I'm gonna put her in now. Now there is one other essential piece of kit to using this. These neoprene waders. You need a good pair of watertight chest waders. In Ireland, the water's usually pretty cold, so I always use neoprenes. And there's one thing that goes with the neoprene waders, and that is propulsion. A set of fins. Now there are fins that are specially made for float tubes, but I've always found that they're too small. These are diver's fins, and you get far more propulsion with these. The only thing you've got to be absolutely certain of is that you get fins that aren't booty types. These are the opened end one, so the whole wader foot goes in there, strap goes round the back, pull it tight, safe as houses. Just a wee tip when you're walking around with fins on, always walk backwards. If you try walking forwards with a pair on. This is my seat. I just sit on this little piece of webbing. This comes up between the legs and clips in here, stop you disappearing down in the hole. And that's you. Well, it might look precarious, folks, but it's actually a lot of fun. And the amount of mobility that you have with a pair of fins on is surprising. Yes, and we're in. Excellent. I just put out a slightly longer line, cover a bit of new water, and instantly up comes a little head. He's swimming straight for me. Up comes a little head and he's taking the point fly this time. I always fish a team of three, and he's not a bad fish. When you're fishing from a tube, you don't want to have too long a leader, because otherwise your bob fly will be up to the top eye and you'll still have too much line out. Now that is just beautiful. That one came to a black panel. Good old favourite Irish trout fly. Any black fly, floating line, team of three across the top. Just as long as you don't have too much sun, you're in business. There he goes. Oh, and I just missed another one. I'll certainly put another line in there. Oh, there's a fish, and he came up to the fly, and he took again. Yes, I got him the second time. This is a better fish now, by the feel of it. Oh, no, I'm mistaken. He felt a good fish there. He came up. Oh, I tell you why, he's... he's foul hooked. That can be very deceptive. You foul hook a fish, he always feels bigger than he is. Come on, little fellow, I'll let you off now. And he's away. Excellent. We've had a prolonged spell now of bright sunshine. And these little wild trout and bright sun don't go too well together. So I'm going myself for a bit of pike fishing. Well, the conditions now are probably better for trout than when it was fly fishing for trout. The sun seems to have disappeared more or less permanently, although we might still see a glimpse of or two of it. The wind has dropped, and I'm now fishing for pike. I've moved to this little pike lake. It's particularly good for fly fishing because it's shallow, and any pike lying on the bottom anywhere in this lake is within striking range of the surface. So I'm surface fishing. I'm using a Ballydoola bomber, which is a good fish imitation, with an intermediate line. And I'm stroking it across the surface just deep enough to make a bow wave in the surface, breaking surface regularly, and that creates the disturbance that attracts the pike. Hopefully we should see some spectacular surface takes.
Got him.
Oh.
Ah.
Oh. Ooh. He didn't like that. What about that for a bit of acrobatics? Ah. I don't think he's ready for it yet. I think he expended it all in that one spectacular burst. Ah! Oh. I don't think so. There he's off again. Ah! Oh, excellent. Now there is a beautiful fish. I'd say a good 7-8 pounds. You know, float tubes add a really wonderful new dimension to fly fishing, or fishing of any kind. It's sort of a cross between wading and boating and swimming, and being in the water with the fish really is a lot of fun, and that's even better fun getting one of those at the end of the day. Thank you.